Chapter 10, Home Before Dark. A bird began to sing. Jack opened his eyes. He was still pointing at the picture of the frog. Creek was.
Greek.
Weak. Weak was. He peeked out the treehouse window. Outside, he saw the exact same
view.
We are home, whispered Amy. The walls were lit with a golden late after moonlight. The sun was about to set. No time had passed since they'd left. Jack, Amy, a
voice
called from the distance. Let mom, said Amy, pointing. Jack say, so their mother there.
Far away.
She was standing in front of their house. She looked very
teeny.
Amy, Jack, she called. Amy stuck her head out the window and shouted, come in. Jack still felt dazed. He just stared at Amy. What happened to us? He said. We took a trip in the magic tree house, said Amy, sleepy.
Simply,
but it's the same time as when we left, said Jack. Amy shrugged. And how did it take us so far away, said Jack. And so long ago, you just looked at a book and said you wished we could go there, said Amy. And the magic tree house took us there. But how, said Jack. And how, who built this magic tree house? Who put all these books there?
A magic here.
A magic person. A ghost.
I guess,
said Amy. A magic person.
Person.
Oh, look, said Jack. I almost forgot about this. He reached into his pocket and pulled out the gold
medallion.
Someone lost this book there.
Big.
There. In Dinosaur Land. Look, there's letter M on it. Amy's eyes got round. You think M stands for magic person, she said. I don't know, said Jack. I just know someone went to late place before us. Jack, Amy, come the distant cried again. Amy poked her hand out the window. "Come in," she shouted. Jack put the gaunt medallion back in his pocket. He pulled the window dinosaur book out of his pack and put it back with all the other books. Then he and Annie took one last look around the tree house. "Goodbye, house," whispered Annie. Jack slung his backpack over his shoulder. He pointed at the ladder. Amy started down. Jack followed. Second later, they hopped onto the ground and started walking out of the woods. "No one's going to believe our story, said Jack. "So let's not tell anyone," said Annie. "Dad won't
believe it,
said Jack. "He'll say it was a dream," said Annie. "Mom won't believe it," said Jack. "She'll say it was pretend," said Annie. "My teacher won't believe it," said Jack. "She'll say you're nuts," said Annie. "We better not tell anyone," said Jack.
I already
said that," said Annie. Jack sighed. "I think started not believe it myself," said he. Said they left the walls and start up the road toward their house. As they walked past all the house on their street, the trip of two dinosaur time did seem more and more like a dream. Only this world at this time seemed real. Jack reached into his pocket. He clasped the gaunt medallion. He felt the engraving of the letter M. It made Jack's finger tingle. Jack laughed suddenly. He felt very happy. He couldn't explain what had happened today, but he knew for sure that their trip in the magic treehouse had been real.
Absolutely
real. Tomorrow.
Tomorrow,
Jack said softly. We'll go back to the walls. Of course, said Amy. And we'll climb up to the treehouse, said Jack. Of course, said Annie. And we'll see that happening next, said Jack. Of course, said Annie. Rest you. And they took off together, running for home.